Hey guys, in this video we're going to go over how to use Excel to find a mean, a median, a mode, a standard deviation, and a five-number summary. So the example that we have was data collected from 16 random wolf dens in Arizona, and they counted the number of wolf pups that were in each den. So if we're trying to find this information, step one is we need our data to be sorted. So I'm going to highlight all of my information and sort it from smallest to largest. Once you have your data sorted, you can start working out these different things. Now, for a mean, the function in Excel is called average. So average, open parentheses, and highlight all of your data points. Close parentheses, and hit enter. And it will find a median, which is really just an average. Now, median, the function in Excel is called median, so it's really easy to remember. Open parentheses, and again, highlight everything. Close parentheses, and you're done. Now, mode in Excel equals mode dot SNGL. This is the one we want to use that will do what we want it to do. So you open parentheses and highlight everything. When you close parentheses and enter, it will give you the mode. Now remember, mode means the thing that happens most frequently, and that is obviously the number five. It happens five times in our set of data. What you need to realize is that in Excel, it will only give you one mode. So you have to manually go through and check if anything else happens the same number of times as five, which in this case, it does not, because everything else happens either two times or only once. So just remember to check for that. Now, standard deviation in Excel is equals STDEV dot. We want dot S because we're doing a standard deviation for a sample. Then you can open parentheses and highlight everything, close parentheses, and hit enter, and it will calculate standard deviation for us. So now that that's done, we can work on our five number summary. Now, as you can see, I listed what the five numbers are that we need. Low value is fairly obvious. We can read it off. It is just a 3. High value is also obvious. Read it from our chart. It's just a 9. Now, quartile 1 is the median of the small half of the numbers. So we're going to have to split our numbers in half so that we can find that. Quartile 2 is the overall median of the set. Now, we already worked that over here, but let's go ahead and put it in here also. Equals median, open parentheses, and it's the overall data set. So you highlight everything when you're doing quartile 2. Close parentheses and hit enter. Then quartile 3 is the median of the large half of the numbers. So the next thing I need to do to find these two quartiles is split this in half. And since I know there are 16, I'm going to highlight the first 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and put a box around them so that I can tell that these are my small half of the numbers. And then this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 would be the large half of the numbers. Quartile 1 is equal to a median, but when you do it, you only highlight the small half of the numbers. And then you close parentheses and you hit enter. Now, Excel is giving us this little green triangle here, which is a warning. It says the formula in this cell refers to a range that has additional numbers adjacent to us. It's basically giving us a warning that we didn't highlight everything, but we didn't want to. So I'm just going to click here and tell it to ignore the error because it is not an error. Now, quartile 3 is also equal to a median. This time, however, you only highlight the large half of the numbers, and then you can close the parentheses and hit enter. That same warning is happening, so I'm going to again tell Excel to ignore the error. So we have now created a five-number summary for our data set. Well, that's all to this video. I hope you guys found it useful. Thanks for watching. Bye.